I swear, I'm like world's most comfortable real estate agent because look what I got on. Like imagine your real estate agent pulling up, showing your house like this. Like, I mean, I wouldn't care. But girl, we're gonna have to get you a suit. We're gonna have to get you a pantsuit, you know what I'm saying? Maybe put a low bun, maybe some glasses, maybe a billfold or something, you know, suitcase. We're gonna have to make you look a little bit more ugly. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Okay, I'm alive. I'm here, barely, but I'm here. thank you guys so much for like reaching out to me and all your prayers and things like that. Because as you guys know, I do live in Texas and we're going through a little bit of a lot right now. Okay, I was out of power all day yesterday. I had to sit in my car and eat and take my kids out of the house because it was cold and it was just a lot going on yesterday. But thank you guys so much for being patient with me because I know I missed yesterday's upload, but I'm here today. Okay, we're here. So we're just gonna hop right into today. Okay, because that was yesterday. This is today. So let's talk about today. But I made a one-story home today. You guys have been asking me to do that. I'm really trying to take in you guys' requests more often and look and see what you guys want to see and what you're looking for and things like that. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy today's video. But yes, so I did build a one-story home. I'm gonna be giving you guys tips and tricks on one-story floor plans and layouts. Some things are a little bit different, but overall, I really like it and I think you guys are gonna like it too. There's gonna be a speed build at the end of the tour. So if you want to build this specific home, the speed build will be at the end of this tour. Okay, so don't even worry because a lot of y'all be watching my videos halfway through and be like, oh, you need to do a speed build. It'd be at the end. But anyways, okay, so let's hop right into this. So here is the one-story home that we're working with. And honestly, I took a lot of components from my own home because I live in a one-story home. So a lot of components are from my own home. But yeah, so as you can see the fence from the front, which I think is really nice when it comes to one-story homes and make it look a lot less dry. It makes the curb appeal and like the front just look a little bit better. We have a pretty long driveway. I noticed a lot of one-story homes have long driveways. I have my classic mediocre landscaping going on here. Y'all know how I do. You know, I just realized I didn't add any trees to this. I didn't add any trees. I'm gonna have to add some trees. I don't like this. Hold on. Okay, I just add a little bit, just a few trees. I don't know. I just need to add trees to my homes. But anyway, what? Anywho, let's just walk right in. As you guys can see, I have the front porch. As I say, let's walk right in while I'm talking about the front porch and not even walking in. But I have the front porch right here. You know how I do the porch with the roof in the basement. We have a two-car garage right here, and I think that's like a big thing. You really want to do a two-car garage when you're doing a one-story home because it's gonna make the home appear a lot bigger. And a lot of times when I see people building one-story homes, they make them look like little tiny shacks when no, one-story homes can have two car garages. So you know, just keep that in mind. We have the little archway that I'm gonna show you guys how to make in a speed build, but you guys most likely already know how to make it. I did it in a few of my videos before, but now we can walk in. Okay, so this is how it looks when you first walk in the home. To the right is going to be the dining area. So where the dining table and stuff is going to be to the right because that's important. And then to the left right here, this is going to be either a laundry room or a half bathroom. I always tell you guys, I usually put a laundry room and a half bathroom. They're both the same size. So you can either, you know, make it either or. I will put a half bathroom right here though, just because it's right by the front door and it makes it easy for guests to have to go to the bathroom without trotting all through your house. So yeah, that's that. And as you can see right here, I have kind of like a, I don't know if you can see, but I have like the little small fence thing to make a marker between the kitchen and the living room because I really wanted carpet in this home. I don't know. Y'all, I'm trying to single-handedly bring carpet back in style. So yeah, everybody put carpet in your home so we can make that happen. But yeah, this is the living room over here. The TV can go on the fireplace. We have the classic bookshelves that I put on each side of the fireplace. You guys know how to do. I would have put a window right here, you know, to bring in more natural light, but there's a bedroom right here. So, and that's kind of like, and then behind the bookshelf, there's a closet. So it's like, I can't even put more windows. So that's like, something that I kind of wanted to do, but I couldn't do. But it is what it is. I still like the way it looks. To the left, we have the kitchen, which I really like how the kitchen came out. You guys know how I do my little drive-through thing. You already know. This will be like the little sitting area. So like your breakfast nook type of area where you sit, eat your breakfast, whatever. That's going to be right there. We have the island in the center. And this is the full kitchen area. Really like how the kitchen came out. This is the walk-in pantry. And yeah, this is the kitchen. As you can see the living room from it. Really nice. We have some beams up here just to create a little bit something interesting as far as the ceiling goes. So yeah, that's that. And then we're gonna go right through here. This is the entrance to the backyard. The backyard entrance is to the side, but this is a wraparound backyard. So over here it wraps around because this is exactly how my backyard is. So yeah, a lot of homes do have entrances to the backyard on the side, so don't even worry about that. It's still a backyard, side yard. This is the laundry room or half bathroom. You guys know, you know the drill. And this is just the garage. This is your plain regular degla garage. You walk in, it's like a little mini hallway type of deal before you get to the kitchen. And honestly, I really like how this came out. Like, this is very spacious for a one-story home. A lot of people think a one-story home cannot be spacious, but it definitely can. The main tip, you have to make the home a lot longer instead of wider. So that's one tip. I know with two-story homes, you know, you can make them whatever size, and you can, whatever you didn't put on the first floor, you can put on the second floor. But with these homes, you don't have that option. So you definitely want to make the homes a lot wider, a lot longer and a lot bigger. And I'm going to show you when I do the speed build. But to the left, this is the first bedroom right here. And this is just a kid's bedroom or whoever. It has a sliding closet right here with this little shelf. You know how closets usually have shelves in them. So that's that, and that's the closet. And I like the little, I like the natural light that comes in this room. It's really cute. And the rooms are huge. Like, the rooms are huge. You could probably, no, I wasn't going to say you could split this and make this two bedrooms, but that's going to be doing a lot. So just keep the big bedroom, okay? You can maybe add a bathroom so they can have their own bathroom. That'd be cool. But I didn't do that because there's only one bathroom that the kids are going to share. So this bedroom does have 2.5 bathrooms. So yeah, we can go over here to the master. This is the master bedroom. Master bedroom is huge because it's a master bedroom. It's supposed to be. And it has its own bathroom, the master bathroom, because it's a master bedroom, so it needs its own bathroom. Going right over here is a walk-in closet. I added some shelves. Actually, let me turn that light off because the light is a little bright. But I added some shelves to make it, you know, so we can put their clothes, hang your clothes or whatever, because this is a walk-in closet and a lot of closets have built-in shelves in them. So that's why I did that. And let's exit out of here. This is a hallway closet because I noticed I don't put these in my homes a lot. And most homes, almost majority, all homes have this. And I didn't put one. But this is, yeah, the hallway closet. So just where you put hallway stuff, tiles and whatnot, the broom, the vacuum. This is the third bedroom. Really nice. Like the lighting. This is so cute. It has its own closet as well with the shelves in there. Like I said, really like this bedroom, because it's like tucked in the corner. It's really cute, really cozy. Let's get up out of here. And then here is the kids' bathroom that they share. And you see it's pretty big, so it's enough for them to share. Because you don't want them in no cramped space, fighting, trying to brush their teeth in the morning. Like, thank you. But yeah, so that's pretty much the home. And as you can see, like I said, it's like longer. You go all the way back here, there's like bedrooms and bathrooms all down this hall, and that's like the main thing that you want to do when building a one-story home. You want to make sure that there's enough space, okay? Because you're putting all the bedrooms, office, backyard, pool, closets, bathroom, you're putting all that on one floor. So definitely keep that in mind. Do not make it tight. Do not make it small and cramped. Definitely give it some room. Give it some space. But as you can see, you can still make a really nice suburban home and make it one story. For the people that don't have the multiple floors game pass, you can still make a really nice home. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the tour. I'm just gonna hop right into the speed build, which is about to happen right now. What's up, guys? This is Speed Build Jasmine talking. Hello. Hi. How you doing? Great. Great. As you can see, I'm just doing the garage first because either home I do, whether that's a two-story home or a one-story home, I'm always going to do the garage first. And with this home, I'm trying to get the shape down. I realize that that's going to be way too small to do a one-story home because I realize I have to fit all these big bedrooms on one floor. So yeah, I tried to go and make it a little bit bigger. Now I'm just placing the roofs the way I want the roofs to look. I'm going for a gable roof type of look because I'm obsessed with gable roofs. Love them. And then I'm going to delete those walls and then place the main roof down just so all the roofs kind of connect with each other and they kind of like mold right in together, if that makes any sense. But I was kind of struggling a little bit, so I believe I end up going with a hip roof because the gable roof just wasn't doing it for me. It wasn't giving what it said it was supposed to give, so I just end up deleting those and I think I went in with a hip roof. Yeah, I might skip this part. I'm not sure because I was struggling a little bit, y'all. I was struggling. But I know for sure I'm going to end up... Look at me just sitting here. I didn't even skip this part. But I know for sure I'm going to end up doing the floor plan first, which I never do. But I had to figure out how I was going to make this one-story home work. And it ended up working. So as you can see, I'm making the bedrooms right now. That's going to be the little hallway that leads to the bedrooms. I end up adding that little hallway closet last, like later, so you're not gonna see it in this speed build, but you guys know it's there. I did have a wider archway at first, and then I end up making it smaller because I wanted to put the little drive-through kitchen type of deal right there. I'm just adding my laundry room, half bathroom, and the little hallway and whatnot. So yeah, I'm just sectioning it off. And I told you guys in my other floor plan video how you want the house to kind of flow and make a little bit of sense. But one-story homes, you can kind of do it a little bit differently. When you first walk in, you can have a bedroom right there in the front of the home. There's plenty of homes that are like that. They have the bedrooms in the front, in the kitchen, and everything in the back. You can definitely do that. And if you want me to do a floor plan that's like that, then definitely let me know if you kind of like want to see a different type of floor plan where I have like bedrooms in the front and everything in the back. I can definitely do that because I'm trying to expand my building and build different things that I wouldn't typically build, which is like a one-story home, because believe it or not, I never built one before. I've always built two-story homes, which is kind of funny because I don't live in a two-story home. So it's just like, what, girl, like what's going on? But yeah, I really enjoyed this build, really love how it came out. I'm just adding like the little porch thing, you know, trying to get some detailing. I added some trim. Now I'm doing my little archway thing that you guys see me doing my big family home, suburban home. I'm just doing that because I really like the way those look and I'm like obsessed with doing those now. So yeah, I'm just adding that and I'm trying to figure out what door frame I'm gonna use. I was kind of struggling with that, but we end up getting it. But yeah, so back to the floor plans. You kind of just want them to flow. I feel like the main things to have in your home are living rooms, kitchens, and put a pantry in your kitchen. I feel like a lot of people don't put pantries in their kitchen when majority pantries have kitchens. Okay, no, majority kitchens have pantries, so definitely don't forget that. Add a hallway closet. I keep forgetting about hallway closets, but definitely add one. Make sure you have a laundry room, half bathroom. Half bathrooms are so important. And make sure they're towards the front of the home. You don't have to go and try and, you know, track and mud through somebody's bedroom to go to the bathroom, okay? If the pizza man ring your door, he got to go to the bathroom. You don't want him all up in your bedroom. So, yeah, definitely don't forget to have a half bathroom. Have a dining room, okay? Have a fireplace. Like, these are like, you know, simple things. Now I'm just making a pathway. But this speed build is very, very short because I didn't show myself doing the actual interior, like as far as like the walls and the floors, because you guys seen that so many times and I kind of forgot to record it. But you guys seen it so many times. But yeah, you got the gist of it. If you guys want to copy this house, then here's the floor plan to it. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed my mini speed build video, okay? Let's go back to regular Jasmine. Alrighty, so that's it for today's video, guys. I know it was kind of quick, okay? It was kind of sped through, but I was trying to hurry up and post something before my electricity goes out again because I don't know what's going on this week. This week is a little wonky, okay? So I was trying to hurry up, post something, and have some content for you guys, okay? Provide something informative for you guys. So I hope this video helped you. I hope you guys start making more one-story homes, okay? Don't be scared to make one-story homes. They're fun. They can be big. They can be family. They can be cozy. Okay, so yeah, definitely try out some one-story homes. Please send me some pictures if you do. Send them in my Discord. I would love to see them. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because we are almost at, what, 10K. And speaking of that, thank you guys so much for 9K. I didn't even get to thank y'all. Okay, thank you guys so much for 9K. Oh my goodness, this is crazy. I can't even believe this is happening. And we're about to hit 10K. Like, this is insane. You guys know what happens at 10K. You already know. I ain't even got to tell you because you already know. But yeah, definitely leave more video suggestions down below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.